Hello everyone, I am Amit. Welcome to my channel, Lecture by Mr. Dhomle. In this video, we will going to take one more Python project or a mini project where we will going to check a spelling of the word. As you can see, I have written one program and I am using a Jupyter Anaconda. It is a Google Colab. If you want, you can run it on your local Jupyter Anaconda also. But I am preferring to use a Google Colab. So here I will first show you the output, then we will see how the code is written and what is the meaning of each and every instruction. So in order to run in a Google Colab, you just need to click on this arrow button. Once you click on this arrow button, you see it is asking you to enter a word. Let me put any wrong spelling word. So I'm just putting this check. Okay, so you can see I have written wrong. It's already giving me the red line, but let's see whether it is correct or not. So when I press enter, it is showing it's not checked though, it's a check. Now it will going to ask you whether you want to continue or not. So here I use the ternary operator, and based on that 1 or 0, 1 means yes, I want to continue, and 0 means no, I don't want to continue. So 1 means yes, I want to continue, and check for other, and 0 means no, and I don't want to check for other. So 1 means yes, I want to continue and check for other. And 0 means no, I don't want to continue, I am okay with that. So now here, let's suppose if you want to continue, just press 1 and enter. Now enter any other word. So let's take, in place of goes, I'm typing 0 s g-o-s-e. Normally the goes is g-o-e-s, right? So let's press enter. Now it is showing you that it is a rose. I think that the compiler might have understood this as a rose, because it completely depend on the library that you are using. Okay, let me try with another word. I want to continue, so I press 1, and instead of going, I'm pressing one more enter word. Here I have added one more character n, and in this going n, let's check whether it is correct or not. So when I press, it's showing that it's not going and it's going. I want to continue, so press 1 again, and let's check for texting is correct, right? Because texting is not correct, testing is correct. So this original texting means there is no word exist on in the dictionary, there is no word exist any texting. It is a testing, so it has printed testing. So here all the things are performed by your library. This text block, this is the main library which is used in the NLP for natural language processing, and it read the word based on the each and every character and find it out whether it is correct or not. So this text blob is actually a Python file that are present in this text blob package, and this text block define a set of words. So based on that, it is testing. Whatever value we are entering, it's check whether this present or not. So there is no texting kind of keyword or a word present in the dictionary of the text block. Similarly, let's try for any other word. In original spelling is O-R-I-G-A-N-A-L, right? So let's take N-E-L and try it. So it's showing, okay, sorry, I have written wrong here. I wanted to enter this 1 or 0, I have entered the wrong. So let's run 1 again. Okay, then let's see O-R-G-I-N-E-L. In place of original, I'm passing this. Let's press enter. So see, it is printing. Now if you don't want to continue, press 0 and just press enter. So it has stopped working. So in this video, I've explained you how you can create this spell check program. So in this spell check program, what I have done it here, I have imported this text blob library which is available in the Python. It is used in NLP. And I assign one to this one variable t. Why I assign one? So in normal programming methodology, one means always true and zero means false, or it is one means yes, zero means false. So when I pass it here, when I write one while t, it means that the t will assign with one. It means that why I have written like this, so that this condition will always be true. If I want to assign zero, in that case itself, it will not work. Here, I have assigned it here. You can see t is equal to int input, means here I am accepting the input from a user. And here I have written this, it is in the form of ternary operator kind of thing. Here I have written in that way, but here I am just accepting the input, and that input will be passed to this while loop. You can see here, this is the condition checking. So here I'm checking the condition. As t value will be 1, it will assign to this. You will enter a word to be checked. Then you will convert that word into the string. Okay, with this str function, you will convert that or you will going to print that function, print that text into the string form. Then here with this variable b is equal to text blob e, you will going to correct the text. When you call this text blob, you can see here, when I put the cursor here, it is showing me that this text block is kind of a function in the text block library, which is going to check for the text there's present in the sentence, or it is going to check the character present in the word. And once it check it, you are going to print it. The correct text is equal to strb.correct. So you are going to call one function that is correct. You can see when I put the cursor there, it is showing me def correct. So it will going to call that function correct, which is defined in this text block. So it will do, it will going to correct this b dot correct. B is what the character or the string that you have written here. So it will going to convert into this text block, means the text block will going to read this a, will be assigned to b, and you will going to convert it, and you will going to correct it. So this is the instruction for correcting the string and print it. So here, once you print it, you can check it here whether you want to accept an input 1 or 0. If we enter 1, then it will assign 1 here again, and you will follow the same procedure. If it is 0, it will assign the value again and you will stop. 0 means, you can see I have written the comment also, 0 means no, I don't want to check for other word. And 1 means yes, I want to continue and check for other word. So in this way, in this video, I've explained you how you can do this spell check. Let's run once again and let me clear you how it works. So here, let's take one more example in case in what is the spelling of again, A-G-A-I-N. So I'm taking N-I, okay, and I will going to press enter. So see, it is going to print corrected test is again. Now I want to continue. I will press 1 and press enter. So as you enter 1, it will assign here to T. It will going to prompt you, enter the word to be checked as it prompted me. I will going to enter whatever value I will going to enter here. Let's take a wording. So let's see what improvement or what correction they are doing to this word. So when I assign wording, it will going to take it as a string. Then it will going to assign the text block value of this particular character to B, means it will going to check in this text block library whether this word is present or not. Then it will assign to this B, and you will going to correct the text by using the correct function. And then why we are using this str, we just convert it into the string. And let me press enter. So see, it is showing that there is a kind of wording is still present on this text block. It means that the corrected text is correct. What I have entered is correct. Now let's check for once again. I will press 1. I want to continue. So let's check for yes. So instead of yes, I use yes. So let's check what it is giving for this yes word. So when I press, it is showing where. So I think that this library, this text block library, they are taking this yes as a where. Let's take one more word. Okay, I need to enter here one or zero. So I will press enter one. I wanted to continue, and I will enter one word, beacon. Let's see what is giving. So you see here, there's no keyword present beacon in the dictionary. In this text block, the word is beacon. So in this way, in this video, I've shown you how you can write a program in a Python with the help of text block library, and you can check the spell of the word. You can check the spelling of the word. Now I don't want to continue, so I will just simply press zero here. I don't want to check for other word, so I will press zero and I will press enter. So it will stop asking you or prompting you to enter more word. So till then, bye. So in this way, I explain you how you can do the spelling check with the help of Python code and with the help of text block library. If you like the video, then please subscribe it, comment it, and share it. In the next video, we will come up with the more project. Till then, bye.